Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes in the Sky. What's up this week? Our sun is a largely stable G spectral class dwarf star that basically does a nice job for life on Earth by being like a Goldilocks type star. Not too hot, not too cold, but just right for where Earth revolves around the sun. And it's been doing that for billions of years too, though it will increase enough in temperature 800 million years from now to boil off all the water in our oceans. So get your spaceships ready. Okay, but seriously, various views of stars are a lot of what gets discussed here on Eyes on the Sky. And what better way to observe a star than to look at the closest one to us? Of course, there are a number of safeguards to avoid damaging your eyes, which you can learn about in a video I made last year about solar viewing safety. 2 points I will reiterate here though, please. Do not use the screw-on eyepiece filters, which can crack and allow unfiltered sunlight to pass through, and always use either approved visual use filters or at least number 14 welder's glass only for solar observing. So, what to look for? First of all, sunspots. These are darker regions on the photosphere of the sun, which appear this way because they are cooler than the surrounding areas by 1300 to 2800 degrees Kelvin. They are caused by intense magnetic fields and often come in pairs, with the two poles of the magnetic field making up the pair of sunspots. Sometimes they are small, but many can be larger than the size of Earth. And for the largest ones, you don't even need a telescope. Holding up a solar filter over your eyes may be enough to see the largest ones. Typically, sunspots are seen along two regions, above and below the sun's equator, and rotate across the surface. Now, the sun's rotational period is just over 25 days, so many sunspot groups are visible for up to 2 weeks at a time, and may even reappear after passing around the opposite side. Though a significant level of sunspot activity peaked in 2011, the actual peak for sunspots should occur later this year, providing observers with a double peak of activity that started in 2011 and may continue and re-peak in 2013. Even if the second peak fails to materialize, we are still witnessing around 50 plus sunspots per month presently. And now this week's dark sky fact. A sunset glow has red-shifted light. This helps your body recognize nighttime. But computer screens have blue-shifted light, so download the free program Flux to automatically change your computer screen every day to red-shifted light when the light outside does at sunset. Another feature to look for is faculae. Instead of dark areas on the surface like sunspots, faculae are brighter areas that are also associated with magnetic fields. They are often around or near sunspots, but sunspots are not required for them to be present. Faculae are often easier to see near the limb of the sun, but very bright ones may be seen in the center as well. Often they can be quite subtle and initially not as easy to spot as sunspots are. One of the most dramatic ways to view the sun, though, is with a telescope that has a special hydrogen alpha filter. Now, these are quite a bit more expensive than regular visual filters because they are tuned to a very specific wavelength of light that allows us to see solar flares and prominences along the sun's limb. Because telescopes and filters that do that start in the $700 to $1,000 range and up, many of us do not have them, but you can still see those prominences on the sun. I'll have a link at eyesinthesky.com where you can see the sun at those various wavelengths of light. The best part about observing the sun, though, is that it is always changing. There's always something new and different to see, even day to day. Saturn is stationary on July 9th, and over the course of several days, you can see how little it moves compared to Kappa Virginis. The moon will be 7 degrees from Venus on the 10th. Look for this pairing about an hour after sunset, local time. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.